Good afternoon. Welcome to another Cat Dev update. Today is Friday, October 22nd, and it's Friday, so everything's going swell. It's my day off today, so I'm gonna do features today as I usually do for tech or development. So I was looking on the internet today to see which product I would review today and discuss their features. I knew I had in mind that I was gonna do Google last week products. So I did look at Google and then look at a few other things. So I said, well, I'll do Google today. And I came across some Google machine learning products. So I'm gonna do Google today. But I really was thinking originally to do something that it was inclusive of mechanical engineering and people that develop using actual products, not just software, not just for software developers. So I was thinking, well, maybe I should do something with Raspberry Pi. And I came across Google TensorFlow and Azure ML. So Azure ML does have, is inclusive of Raspberry Pi projects. So I'm gonna do that today. It was perfect. It came across well because I found something that was inclusive of Raspberry Pi, which you can do, you know, start like a small project in machine learning and using Raspberry Pi. So I was looking on the internet, I found Google TensorFlow, which they also have a community day coming up in November. So Google TensorFlow uses Python and C++ 11. So I'm gonna use my paper definitely for right now. So basically I'm gonna do machine learning tools. One is for enterprise and one is for data scientists. I'm assuming that, I think that the TensorFlow is probably you can use it for any small project and it's not just for, you know, like big companies. And then Azure ML is enterprise, more enterprise based, more for data scientists. So like I was looking at TensorFlow and reading up on it. It's an open source platform. Basically it deploys machine learning powered applications. Basically you're just training your neural networks you're using your data, training your network, and then the output of whatever you're on your data set, whatever the results are from your data set and your training models comes out, whatever. So I came across a small project. It's audio classification with Raspberry Pi RP2040. So this is published on October 6th, 2020, and it's on the TensorFlow blog. There is a bug on me. Good Lord. Excuse me for one second. So there's on TensorFlow. So TensorFlow uses machine learning for embedded microcontrollers in devices like microwaves, things like that. So, and wearables. God, this bug's on me. And I'm outside today because, I'm just outside. I'm working with the elements. It's raining today and whatever. So TensorFlow, you can also do your machine learning for smart speakers and wearables. So if anybody's into designing wearables, which I know is another whole set of columns, whatever, I don't know, doing wearables, stuff like that. I thought about getting into doing something like that, but that, I don't know, whatever. So, TensorFlow, is, I think, all around inclusive, like for like a one person, if you just want to do like a small project, up to a big company that wanted to use it for their applications. So other companies that are getting in on this machine learning and artificial intelligence, hey bird, get away from my bag. Sony, which I did not know that Sony was into developing. I mean, I know that they're into developing because they do have a lot of products, but I didn't know that they were probably so advanced. And they have a developer portal, which is somewhat like Google. So Sony has machine learning, which is Sprinsense. I'm not sure how to say it. That's their AI solution, machine learning solution. It's end to end. So, okay, I'll go back to the project. So the project, audio classifications with Raspberry Pi. It's an end-to-end tiny machine learning audio classification with Raspberry Pi. So basically you're going to capture, basically it's just capturing, it's a project where you capture audio with a microphone to detect small words like yes and no. Basically, I guess you can use like any sound, like say you have a project and you wanted to classify bird sounds. You can build your own little Raspberry Pi project and start classifying the audio. And then I don't know what you would do with that in the end. So if say you wanted to classify, what's a bird here? Let me think. There's something biting me. Okay. Say you wanted to classify robins and you wanted to build your little speaker or your microphone to, classify robins in certain area. So you just, you build your neural networks and you build your models to detect those sounds or whatever. And that's what this project is for Raspberry Pi, using TensorFlow, which uses Python and C++ 11. So if you're a Python person and you're a C++ person, you can use this. So it's micro speech captures audio with the microphone to detect words yes and no. It also has Magic Wand, which captures accelerometer data to classify three different physical gestures. So it's not just sound, it actually classifies physical gestures. So I guess in terms of like the people that are doing the self-driving cars. So that's, I guess, you would include that, any kind of gesture, like body, like temperature, like I guess they include all that data into their data sets when they do their fine tuning, like the Tesla people. I'm sure they do that, right? Physical gestures. I don't know. Somebody walking across the street, I'm sure the car's going to stop. You know what I mean? So using Python 3.7 and TensorFlow 2.0. So there's a GitHub repository for TensorFlow on GitHub.com. It's GitHub.com TensorFlow/TensorFlow Lite. So that's one. Now, Azure is from Microsoft. So Azure is machine learning enterprise grade. It's a machine learning service to deploy and build applications. It's automated. It uses Jupyter Notebooks. So if you are, familiar with Jupyter Notebooks, it has drag and drop designer. It supports PyCharm, VS Code, R, machine learning flow, and Python. So it supports a lot, this Azure. I guess they would have to, because suppose you're an Azure person and you are working in Azure for whatever. It has all these, features across the board. VS Code, R. I'm familiar with R because I did a project. I had started to do a project in school with R. So I didn't really have to use it because we were using a different system. So different programming language or whatever. Different, the one that used. I can't even think of the name of it, but I'll think of it later. It is, what were we doing in school with our data sets? I forgot the name of it. I'll think of it later and I'll post it. So Azure uses VS Code, R. R is not that bad. I think I was able to get a grasp on R. It wasn't, and I had just started learning the other product that we were using for that data science class. I forgot, but not the data science class, but it was a different class that's similar to a data science class. I'll think of it later and I'll post it. So ml.azure.com. You deploy and publish real-time batches. There's also machine learning ops, so it's DevOps for machine learning, where you can have a machine learning pipeline and scheduling, which is great. Then I thought about, well, what is the most important thing to machine learning? And that's the data. Learning how to train your data and the type of data that you're inputting into your data sets or into your into your pipeline. So I Googled some data sets. They do have different data sets on the internet, and I'll put the web address up here. Links there, a data set. They have a mall customers data set. They have a Flickr 30K data set. They have an Enron email data set. So I guess with data, there's no limit to what kind of data, and there's no limit to the images that you can put on your data set and train your models with. Whatever you want to think of, that's what you can use for your data set. It's all kinds of data that you can use. So that's for Azure. Let me just see what else I have here. Basically, and they were doing like price prediction with your neural networks. You can do that. You can do price prediction, I guess. But that's what we did in our class too. We did a little bit of sales predictions and things like that, which was kind of interesting because my major was software engineering, and I wasn't doing business. So it kind of took me over into the business side. Like, I guess somebody who's majoring in business or something like that, you do look at sales reports, and you look at how sales reports, reflect your sales, like what, how many customers you came in that day, how much inventory you have. So it gave me an idea into the world of business and how they, you know, how people like maybe run their stores or something like that. You know what I mean? Or something like, I guess, like a store like, what's it called? What's the store that does the throwaway clothes? What is that store called? Not Forever 21, where the clothes aren't that expensive. And I will ramble on. So I was, it gives you like an insight to that world, like the business world. If somebody's doing like business and say they wanted to do fashion. So like, we had our data set we used was like sales. And I had a really good teacher, so she was so nice to me. So that class, I got a C in that class. Believe me, trust me, I worked hard in that class. I was determined to get it. I didn't do as well as I think I should have, you know, but I had so many other things going on. I had a full-time job. I was doing this, I was doing that. So it worked out okay. She ended up giving me a C, but that was one of the most interesting classes that I did have. But like I said, my major was software engineering, and it took me to the business side, like the data and the data scientist people. It's a whole totally different world that I wasn't really familiar with. So I really like that part. So then, what else? I'm talking about my data set. I was talking about different data sets that you can use to enhance your projects. And I was trying to do something today that included like mechanical engineering, not just software development, but actual real products that you can touch and feel, not just the software. So that's why I was trying to include that today. I did. So the first one was the Raspberry Pi. And I will put up some Raspberry Pi projects that can be done, like weekend Raspberry Pi projects. And then what else I did today? Then I did the enterprise part of it, which is Azure Machine Learning, which uses DevOps. And also, what else does Azure do? Azure supports different languages like Python, and supports R and different NVS code. So that's it. And it also uses Jupyter Notebooks, which I had heard of Jupyter Notebooks, excuse me. So what else can I say about these two products? TensorFlow is from Google. I don't know where TensorFlow came from or who, like the background on TensorFlow. I might just post it and see who developed TensorFlow. I don't know if Google developed TensorFlow in-house, or they, you know, purchase it from someone else. And I don't know, but Azure, of course, Azure is Microsoft. So it's a lot of companies out here. And then Sony has their own development stuff going on. It's so many, you know, so many things out here that you can get yourself into. So what else were we doing? That's it today. So that was short. Very short. I will put up the links at the bottom to the data sets. I'll put up the links to different like weekend Raspberry Pi projects. And because I also, like I said, I wanted to include something that included like mechanical engineering, people that do like actual, they program for an actual object. And then we also have the data scientists, which would probably use either TensorFlow or Azure ML. I'm not really sure what they use in their daily workflow, but I guess that's one of the stacks or one of the tech tools that they use. I like to find different dev tools. I like searching for dev tools that makes life easier and just, you know, gives you a little bit more excitement about what you're doing. So that's what I like. And I found that today. So thank you. And I may be back next week. I may not. Like I said, I'm going to do these at leisure because I don't know if I'll have the time to do them every week. I may do them every week. I may not. So there's a bug on me. I might do them every week. I may not. I'm not sure. So thank you. And this is Cat Dev signing off.